Got it? So all of you failed in life.
We all failed.
Okay. So this is what is that you are doing? Your personality is with somebody else. And by asking questions, you are finding personality, your personality. Is it right? Is it a game?
Yes.
Is it game or real? In life, throughout your life, you are trying to find out about your personality from society, other people. You cannot ask questions. Every time in your life, you are trying to define yourself in terms of
other people's opinion.
And whole of your life is defining yourself in terms of others. It's true. So, when will you be successful in this definition?
We should define ourselves.
Huh. You said we should define ourselves.
I must.
How many are there? You means how many?
I must define myself.
Okay. So, you are trying to define yourself in terms of society, right? Husband, wife, family, religion, everything. By, they may not ask explicit questions, but internally, ultimately, you are trying to get an answer for yourself. Who am I? Okay. You may, first you start with family, then start with school, then you start with the, everybody has an opinion about you. Right? Ultimately, you are trying to find out who you are from the society. Is it clear? In 5 questions, are you able to find out about yourself?
No.
In life, how old are you now? 50 years, 55 years, 60 years? In 60 years, you must have found out about yourself from the society? Huh? No?
Still no.
Why it's not possible?
Because the roles keep changing and we are different.
The roles keep changing every minute perhaps.
Every minute changes and everybody gives an opinion based on their interest in you. Okay? They have some, each of them have some specific expectation from you. Okay? So that expectation will define you. But question is, what are you?
HTML1 is there.
The cable looks like a blue or something in the back, no?
Maybe it's kept in a different port.
Come, let's go. Loose. Okay. So, this entire module of classes is divided into small prakriyas. Okay. When I say prakriya is Sanskrit word is called process. So this is a small series of processes. Right now what you went through is called who am I or koham asmi prakriya. The idea is whatever spiritual insights which Upanishad and everything has, making into some practical examples and applying my method rather than getting into a lot of theory. So who am I? The question you are asking. So are you familiar with this? Well, let me first ask you a question, okay? let us say you want to give a mark to yourself out of 100, right? How much you know about yourself? How much you know about yourself? How many marks you will give out of 100?
60.
60, good. You are 60 plus? Okay, one mark per year.
Yeah.
Okay. What about anybody else? More than 60, anybody?
I would only give 25.
25.
10.
10.
15.
15. 50. 50.
About
30. 30. So it increases the age, is it?
No.
So now let us understand what we say, I know about myself, okay? There are four aspects of me. One is about me, known to others and not known to myself. Known, not known to others and known to myself. Known to others, not known to myself. Not known to others, not unknown.
Johari window.
Right? Yeah. So, when I say known to others and known to self, everybody knows about me. And I know also. Right? How much percentage is that? Is it big or small?
It's big. Big.
Okay, out of your 30%, how much percent is that? Let's say if you go on to this, you whole thing you're going to 100%. How much is, okay, I know, everybody knows about me and I know about them. What percent?
I would still say 5%.
Yeah. 5%. Okay. So, known to others but not known to myself. Everybody else knows about you, but you don't know. What is that? Your behavior.
Yeah.
Okay? Say that person is always scratching his head in the meeting. Yeah. I mean, you don't know. You are doing something. It's known to others, but you don't know. Correct?
Yeah.
Not known to others and not known to myself also. No, myself I know. These are very secret. I have very deep secrets. You know, the secret what happened, I had not told to anybody. What is the percentage of this?
5%.
Okay. I don't, not known to others and not too known to myself also. How much percentage is there?
100.
Then when you say, I know myself, how much you know? 60%, oh, over 60%? Okay, so which is the larger component of your 60%?
I know the arena, you know. I know that. The blind, of course, I don't know at all.
Right.
The hidden self, I know a lot, all the skeletons in my cupboard. The A and C, I know.
A and C, I know.
B and D, I don't know.
We don't know. So when you say 60% is these two.
Yes, yes.
Right? This class is only about D. Okay. This class is about D, unknown and unknowable.
Unknowable.
Okay, when I say I know myself, you must have seen this, right? Our subconscious, our conscious mind is only 5%, 5 to 10%. Subconscious mind is 95%. Okay, so when I say I know myself, all that I can know is I know consciously. What is subconscious? Your beliefs, emotions, habits, values, reactions, imaginations, which goes deep buried within, they are not available to you. So when I know myself, what is that I know? With this 5 months?
Tip of the iceberg.
With this 5% of the mind? So how much I really know myself?
95%.
My request is, can you just listen rather than noting? Because there's more to, there's no information here. It's only more of questioning, right? So really when you say, I know 60%, what you are really saying is, with 5% of my mind,
I know 60% of that.
That.
From the conscious mind, I know
a little.
So what
we know about ourselves is very little.
Very little.
Okay, but knowing very little is not a problem. Thinking that I know everything, that little I know, is I consider as I know everything. The problem is knowing little is not a problem. Okay, But that little I say, I know everything about myself. And typically, the question put by the wife, even after 25 years, you don't know about me. Oh, the poor husband, he doesn't even know 5% of himself. He is supposed to know 100% of you. So, what happens is our actually we are peeking through a very small window and think that we know something. And there are many things about ourselves which we don't know. And the self is something which we can't know.
Unknowable
also. Okay. So the question is, if it's unknowable, then why are you struggling? Okay, what is the point of the self-realization about? So it's unknowable is not a problem. Okay? Something being unknowable is not a problem. But unknowable, you start thinking as something else, then there's a problem. Okay? So that is what is self-realization is about. Removing the wrong understanding of the self, while self itself is unknowable, okay? It is unknown, unknowable, even the self-realized person. Okay, don't think that a self-realized person knows about himself. He can't. Only thing is, he can't confuse himself with something else.
Right. A very ignorant person confuses that he is something else.
So that confusion is removed. Self-realized person has knows everything about himself. He can't. Self is unknowable because you are that. You are the self. You cannot know about yourself. Here only we can remove the confusion that the self is something else, is confusion can remove. Okay? Don't be under the impression that one day I know myself and I know everything about self. No. Nothing about self can you know. No Upanishad can teach you about the self. Okay? The entire effort of Upanishad and scripture is to remove the misconceptions of the self. Right now you have a misconception of 5% of your mind thinking that I know 60%, 70%. You know, that's a misconception. It is useful for our day-to-day living, practical, yes. Okay? But as a reality, there's no value to it. Have you seen this place? What does it look like?
Jumbled up roads.
Can you think of a person who is like that?
All of us.
More than
that.
More than that. Who is like that? So, in an average day, we get about 70,000 thoughts, 61,000 to 70,000 thoughts. How many thoughts are required for us to make a living? 10 to 50. And rest is all nonsense.
Okay. And repetitive thoughts.
Yeah, and the question is, where did they come from? When I perform a role, okay, the role leaves an impression in me. For example, I am the mother. The child cries or child falls, it leaves an impression in me. In life, we keep on performing roles. Every role leaves an impression in my memory. And these impressions are thoughts. Okay. Is it clear? So, if you have to count these faces, make a guess how many faces you have like that.
Millions.
Make a guess. What is your guess?
About
thousands.
Yeah, each 10. So but these impressions will be there of our past lives as well. So I don't think it's in millions.
Janmas. How many? Each time you play a role.
I left an impression.
Okay. And these roles leave a deep impression in our mind. Some are good and some are bad. So should we have only good impressions only? Not bad impressions?
No, necessarily.
No. I mean, okay, I'll give you an option. You have a filter. Only good impressions go.
No.
Huh?
Basically, mind has captures only the...
No, no, I'll give you a technique by which only good impressions are captured. Is it okay?
Yeah. No. You want no choice, you need to have polarity.
You need polarity.
Good is okay? ಇಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಫಿಲ್ಟರ್ ಕೊಡ್ತೇನೆ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೆಷನ್ಸ್ ರಿಮೂವ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಡೋಣ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಗುಡ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೆಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ ನಾನು ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕ್ ಕೊಡ್ತೇನೆ ರೀ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಕೊಡ್ತೇನೆ ಗುಡ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ರಿಮೂವ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ವಿ ರಿಮೂವ್ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ಇಟ್ ಬಟ್ ಯು ಲೈಕ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕ್ ಯು ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಸೊ ಗುಡ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೆಷನ್ಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ರಿಮೇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ರಿಮೂವ್ ಇಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಇಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಡಾಲ್ No, why is it not okay at all?
Because again, I've got the same roles in the good or bad, that impression is there. I don't want impression.
Roles you cannot escape anyway in life.
But the thoughts will be there over that.
Roles cannot be there. You cannot escape any roles anyway, any time.
You have a body.
You have to have a body. As long as you have a body, you have a role. Actually, you have already come on the stage now. Okay? The stage of life, you are already there. So you cannot say, I won't perform. People will start throwing stones at you. You have to perform something. You have to play a role. The question is, now I'll give a chance to you, keep only good impressions, remove bad impressions, is it okay?
No.
Not okay. Why not okay?
Because I don't know, it's all good. And I learn more when there is both the good and bad. Everything is there. You have the devas, you have the devtas. Okay? So
I'll give you only bad impressions. Good impressions will remove. Is it okay?
No, I need both. I need to know only when there are two, I know this is good.
What about you?
Good impressions.
For good impressions, okay.
Yes.
Actually, good impressions are bad. Okay, tell me one good impression in your life. Very good. Sometime in your child or whatever is it. You went to a nice place or good friends or whatever is it, no?
Yeah, I have good friends.
I had very good friends. You remember now. That means
now
situation is bad. It's a comparison comes in picture. That time it was so good, no? Obviously, by implication, you are saying?
No,
it's not.
The good will always come with the
comparison.
Negative. So, there is nothing in life, I will have only good or I will have only bad.
Good.
Okay? You are bad, very bad. I was went through very bad times. That means yours now is good.
Yes.
Okay? The good and bad, you cannot separate them out. They are a pair. Okay? So many people who are, I want to remove bad impressions. No, it doesn't work that way. What you call as bad is only pointing to good you are going through now. What you consider good, only pointing to
bad
you are trying to point. Right?
Comparing it.
Now, what is the solution? Is it a solution that will remove the impressions? I mean, is there a technique of formatting the hard disk? I mean, erase the memory? There is. Put your finger into electric socket. Fuse ho jayega. Is that what you want? Like, that's the whole spirituality is summarized. Put your
finger. White
out. So, the whole of the spirituality is... No, spirituality is... Learning that these roles and identities are leaving impression in us, and this impression is causing problem to us. Okay? Impression may be there. How I can live with these impressions free from trouble?
Misery.
It's not that you will remove all the impressions. Okay? Not possible. Live with these impressions, but be free from misery. The misery is not the impressions. Misery is when you choose the impressions. Because this is good. So, good impressions you keep on remembering and keep crying now. I lost my good time. Okay. So, you are making a choice in the impressions. You have to be free from choice of impressions. How we can do that is the question. Have you seen this, what do you call this?
The persona
in was the Greek name for a mask. In the drama they used to play, they used to wear a mask. That mask is called persona. Okay.
Yeah.
Right. So the persona, the mask when they wear, they'll play a role. king, thief, all of that. And they must have persona. And that became the word called personality. Whenever you interact with anybody, you wear a mask called personality. Okay? So now question is, how many masks you have in your cupboard?
So many.
Having a mask is not a problem also. But believing that mask is me is a problem. Have you seen this something called Yakshagana?
Yes.
Huh? You know this Yakshagana? You have seen this?
Yes.
Okay. This will go on for 6 o'clock in the night to 6 o'clock in the morning. One good thing about Yakshagana is it's all, what I'm saying is, spontaneous. The dialogues are spontaneous. Okay. The sutradhari or the person who is the running the show, he will tell a poem. And these people will interpret and give their own spontaneous dialogues. The dialogues are not rehearsed. So give a spontaneous dialogue, you have to leave that role. I mean, you have to get fully involved in that role. Yeah. Okay, if you don't get fully involved, you can't give a spontaneous dialogue. So there is a typically something called Devi Mahatme. Devi Mahatme means Devi will kill the demons. So the whole night somebody is playing the role of Devi. By almost 10 or 12 hours, he has become the Devi. And by the early morning, he starts believing that he is really the Devi. And what he does, he takes, there is a sword. Now he thinks other people are demons, other. And he really want to cut their throat. He has got so involved in the play, he wants to cut the throat. And he starts chasing that all those guys. Okay? And that's why in this all the Yakshagana, there are 4 or 5 people waiting for this. That's called Avesha. Avesha means it comes on the
naturally from within.
No, Avesha means
emotion?
No, it's in English called there's a word for that. That like demon demon possessed. They get Devi Avesha. And they become very strong actually. I mean, if 4 people try to hold, because she is Devi, she will jump. Then what they do, they catch hold of that lady, that person, and there are 4 or 5 pumpkins kept. Made to cut the pumpkins. Oh. Then, my God, now you come to normal senses, right? Starts believing that I am Devi. Having a mask is not a problem. The moment you start believing that you are the mask is a problem. Now tell me, how many masks you start believing that you are that mask every day? You understand? Do you do that?
Yes.
Huh?
Of course. When we get totally into something.
I'll give you a very simple solution for that. Every day, make sure that you buy one pumpkin and keep it. When you see the husband and get really become possessed by the wife, and the wife, who are you? Take out the pumpkin, then you become normal person. Otherwise, you'll do some damage to the wife and your children. So we get possessed by our roles. Okay, instead of poor roles possessing us, we start getting possessed by the roles. Right?
Yes.
Everything in life is a role. We should learn the art of not getting possessed by the roles. That is spirituality. Okay, spirituality is not living the roles. Spirituality is not getting possessed by the roles.
Can we live the roles? Because we shouldn't get possessed, but when we have body, mind.
Then you will play the role very well. Okay, you tell me. When Amitabh Bachchan plays the role of a beggar, he acts better than a beggar. Because he is playing the role. Okay? But beggar is in misery. Amitabh Bachchan plays the role with joy. When you play the role well. Right.
So, you complete awareness of the role that I have to do this now and then again step back.
Step back.
Yeah.
Okay. That is the key to spirituality. And the real name of that is called sannyasa. People don't understand. Sannyasa means they think that, oh, taking become a monk. Becoming a monk means play the role, but don't become the role. Okay? You understand? So, and you do that, you will become, you will do very well.